Oh no no no. Yo, my vida, boss little. Call me when I'm feeling sick. Call me when I'm feeling down. Call me when you need someone to talk.
Hey loves, it's Adanna here and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to be trying something very different. I think it's new, I'm not really sure, but thanks to you guys that actually sent me DMs on Instagram asking me to try out this hairstyle and show you guys as well. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. I'm not exactly sure where this needle and yarn thread hairstyle actually started from, but I think it's very innovative. However, the very last, or is it the oldest? I think the oldest video that I see that actually showed how to do this was from Eve Mafupa. That's the name of her channel, Eve Mafupa Natural Sisters. I'm not sure if she's the one that came up with it, but her video is definitely the oldest one here on YouTube that I watched. Okay, so the first thing I went ahead to do was to take down my cornrows. My natural hair was actually in cornrows for about 4 to 5 days, so it's pretty stretched out right now. And I'm going to do like a four flat twists. And then a whole bun at the back. Something really simple but really cute. You know what I mean? Exactly. So I've taken down my cornrows and parted my hair for the section I'm going to be working on right now. I'm going to go ahead to use this yarn thread. I got it from Amazon. I'll be sure to find the link and I'll put it down below in the description box for you guys. I got it from Amazon and I just grabbed this thread and I just looped it through the needle. I passed the thread through the eye of the needle and I also made sure that one side of the thread is way shorter than the other side, just because I didn't want the yarn thread to be doubled on my flat twist, if that makes sense. I wanted it to be like a single yarn. I didn't want it to be doubled, I didn't want it to be too thick. I just wanted like a single yarn flat twist look. It's pretty much up to you, but if you do have natural hair that's very thick, you might have to double the yarn to use like a double yarn, double threaded needle. That's what you might have to do if your hair is pretty thick, just so you can give it that perfect hold. But my hair is not that thick, so just having one strand of yarn does the job for me. Also, if you don't feel comfortable using metal needles, there are also wooden needles you can find. I think I've seen some people use like the wooden needle before. I've never really tried that before, but it basically does the exact same thing. Of course, it's a lot more safe. Only downside of using like the wooden needle is the fact that it's a lot more bulky. So if you're doing like very tiny yarn and needle flat twists, it might be a little bit tough to pass that through your hair if your hair is quite thin and you're trying to do like the very little, you know, the very little flat twist or the very little cornrow with yarn and needle. This entire hairstyle, I was sure to show you guys how I did like every single angle, like the entire 4 flat twists, both from front, back, side, behind, everywhere, okay? You know, you've been struggling to actually achieve a flat twist look. This might be the method for you to try. If you've been struggling with flat twists, this is definitely an easy one. That just involves you passing the thread through your natural hair and just going. And it came out looking pretty good as well. Also a great protective style and also a great way to stretch out your hair using this entire threading method. Now moving on to the next flat twist, I'm going to be explaining to you guys how this entire process actually happens. So now I'll go ahead to part out my natural hair, pat it all the way down to the back. Normally when I'm actually doing my hair by myself, oftentimes I use my phone camera to see if my pattern is straight enough, if it's manageable, because it's never perfect, but I normally just take a picture and then just go back and forth and check if the patterns are okay. And then right now I'll just go ahead to start off with this particular section. To slick down my hair and hold it together, I'm going to be using the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel. I just applied this gel to the sides of this section of my hair that I'm going to be flat twisting, then use my Bristle Brush to brush through just so everything can stay together nice and smooth. Now starting off with this entire needle and thread flat twist, I'm going to go ahead to pass my needle and thread through my natural hair just right here at the beginning while holding down my natural hair. Now grab this end of the thread just right here, put it right there under my fingers, hold it together with my natural hair, and then just go ahead to keep on passing the needle and thread through my natural hair in this motion. So I'm basically going from my right, there you go, that's my right, passing it through for the needle to come out towards my left, and then drag it out from my left and pull it towards my right, poke it in again from my right, just like so, pass the needle and thread all the way through and then pull it from my left. This particular direction that I'm going towards is because I would love my flat twist to come down towards my ear. So I wanted the pattern where the middle is to be flat in such a way that my hair is twisted towards the sides of my ear, if that makes sense. That's why I'm going in this particular direction. So when we move on to the other side of my flat twist, that's the other two sections, at the left side of my hair, you guys will see that the entire threading pattern will be the other way around. Because like I mentioned, I wanted my flat twist to all fall down towards my ear in such a way that the middle of my natural hair is all flat and everything is falling towards the sides. I hope that makes sense, but this is totally up to you. It all depends on the direction that you would love your flat twist to go. So right now I'm just going to go ahead to just keep on doing this entire threading method, passing my needle and yarn all the way through my natural hair while holding down my natural hair just so it stays in place. And then when I get to the final end of this flat twist, I normally just go ahead to take off the needle and just go ahead to wrap the rest of my natural hair all the way down, just like you do the regular African threading. So just keep on wrapping. Get to the point where the thread actually finished, I just go ahead to add new thread and then just keep on wrapping. So when adding the new thread, I normally make sure that I have some extra thread that falls with my natural hair inside, and that way it gives the body of the thread a lot more thickness and it just stays, you know, it stays firm. And then when I get to the very end where my natural hair ends, I just went ahead to just tie this entire yarn and just cut out all the excess yarn that I have left. So this is currently what my twist is looking like at the moment. It's looking pretty good, right? And then moving on to the other section of my natural hair, I'll just go ahead to pat this all the way to the back, just like I did the other side. Hold this side of my natural that I'm currently not working with using my butterfly clamps. And then for this side of my natural that we're working on right now, I just go ahead to comb it and then apply some of my Style Factor Edge Booster gel. Applying the gel, I just went ahead to use my Bristle Brush to brush through my natural hair to make sure that everything is smooth and it's just staying perfectly in place. Prior to starting off with this entire flat twist using this needle and thread, I just went ahead to make sure that I'm holding my natural hair together. So when this needle and thread is just passing through, everything will just be going smoothing, it's be gliding like buttercream, it's just be moving, you know. So right now I'm just going to go ahead to pass this needle and thread through my natural hair, and I held the ends of this yarn, the yarn thread, I held the ends together with my natural hair, and then I just kept on flat twisting, passing this needle and yarn all the way through. As you guys can see, for this side of my natural hair, I'm going from left to right. Needle actually enters from the left side of my head and comes out at the right side of my head, and I just pull this all the way through and then just go ahead to keep on repeating this exact same process until I'm done with this entire flat twist. One thing I really love about this entire flat twist method is because it gives me the illusion of stitch braids. You guys know the stitch braids, you know, the little gap braids. I've always wanted to try those stitch braids, but for me it just never works. Maybe I just don't even know how to do the stitch braids, but this entire method just gives me that stitch braided illusion which I've always wanted to achieve. So I think it's so perfect, especially if you're trying to achieve stitch braids like me and you don't know how to do it. You can try this as well in the Cornrow version, or you can try this in the flat twist version like I'm currently doing. When I get to the very end of this flat twist like I did before, I'll just go ahead to take off the needle and then just go ahead to keep on doing the regular African threading. Thread this all the way to the very end. Knot it right there to keep it tight and properly secured. And then right now I'm just going to move on to the very last flat twist. So this entire hairstyle took me about 35 minutes to achieve. It was pretty fast. It was actually pretty easy. One thing I also forgot to mention is when doing this entire needle and thread flat twist, you want to be careful when you're actually pulling the needle through your natural hair, just because it's quite easy to get this to be a little bit too tight and you don't really want your hair to be pulling too tight. So you just want to make sure that you're putting as little tension as possible on your natural hair without pulling so much. Also for the needle, please make sure that you're using your own personal needle for safety reasons, okay? Very, very important. I'm not going to skip that part. Okay, now I'm just going to allow you guys to keep on watching.
One time me nah mina never. Them a girls them a coming over. Bad man me a wanna lover. Girls come them a be my lover.
bad man. Me, I never waste time. Them a girl, them a come, them a never can time. One time, me, I never waste time. Them a girl, them a come, them a try my time. Ooh, ooh, man, a telling me they go, go. See the girl, them a slow, slow. Bad man on the road, road. See the girl, them go down.
Right now, I'm basically done with this entire flat twist, and I'll just go ahead to hold together the ends of this hair into like a little bun, and I'll use the same yarn thread to hold everything together and make sure that the ends of this flat twist is properly secure in a very nice little bun, because I'll be attaching a Marley full bun right here at the back. Once I'm done putting the ends of this thread into this little bun, I just made sure that I tied it and then cut out all the excess thread. Moving on to this full bun, I'll be using this Marley hair. I've used it before in a previous video. I'm not even sure what a brand of Marley hair this is, to be honest, but I'll find it and I'll put it down below in the description box for you guys. So I grabbed my elastic band, so this elastic band right here, and then passed it through this Marley hair and made it into like a little door handle, and I just went ahead to attach this onto the my natural hair threaded bun at the back. If you don't want to add any full bun to the entire look, you can feel free to rock your natural hair just that way with the entire threaded flat twist, and you would still rock this hairstyle perfectly fine. But I wanted to add a little bit of spice juice. I decided to attach a little full bun right here at the back. To make this entire bun, I just grabbed the Marley hair, splitted it into two equal halves, grabbed one end, twisted it all the way to the very end, and I just went ahead to ravel this all around through my natural threaded bun that we have going on right there, and repeated the exact same thing on this other side, twisted it all the way to the very end, and then went ahead to wrap this all around. And then I used my bobby pins to secure this entire Marley bun, just in case anything is just trying to fall out, so trying to do mistake. Secure it right there just so it doesn't move. And this is basically all I did, you guys. This is literally all I did. That I just went ahead to, you know, do a little bit of edges, swoop, you know, just swoop something, tie this in together, use my satin head wrap, and I just went ahead to do my makeup. I had the head wrap on my head for about 1 hour while I did my makeup. You can also do this the night before, like do your hair the night before. So if you're going to work the following day, you know, you're already the following day, you don't have to do anything much. And then right now, this is all me glammed up, okay? And let you guys know, I have to accessorize my hair. This just takes the look to the next staircase level, okay? I had to find all the accessories wherever it was. I put some rings and then I did the little crown accessories, and that was basically the end of this look, you guys. If you did enjoy this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next one. Love you all so much and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.
It's the original Batman.
One time, it's a Batman team. It's Buddy, baby. V-Kills, let's go. I'ma make you bounce like a hurricane. I'ma make your bed rock like a hurricane. I'ma do it like nobody can. And I'll give you all the things that nobody can. I'ma make you bounce like a hurricane. I'ma make your bed rock like